a murder caught on camera from space. Satellites have captured acts of slaughter before, but they're not always what they seem.
This is Somalia. These are fishermen, and they're gutting their fish right there in the seashore. So what we're literally seeing is fish guts from space. I can actually see blood on the sand.
Satellite experts are confident they can identify blood stains from animal slaughter. But have they ever seen signs of murder?
I can't answer that.
The investigation switches from satellite image analysis to crime scene forensics. California-based blood spatter analyst Tina Young steps in.
The whole image looks very suspicious. There's what appears to be quite a volume of what looks like the characteristics of blood. It's worthy of an investigation.
If it's blood in the image, what could have caused the pattern it makes on the jetty? Tina conducts three blood spatter tests to find out.
One will be a splash pattern. I will take this blood and pour it on the floor. And the second will be an impact pattern. I'll hit the blood with the mallet. And the third will be a transfer drag, and I'll use a cloth to drag through the blood. What we've done here looks very similar to the satellite image. It looks like a splash pattern, possibly also an impact, and it does look like a drag pattern was created.
But Tina's test cannot confirm whether the stain on the jetty is blood.
In order to tell if it is blood, there would be tests that would need to be done at the jetty.
We may have found this initially with satellite image, but there's no way we're going to know what happened for sure till we get boots on the ground, get a CSI team out there, and take a look.
The satellite image showing what looks like blood spatter on a small jetty in Holland was taken in 2009. A crime scene investigation team in Holland decides to check it out. The marks are long gone, but if it was blood, the forensics team hopes some trace of it remains.
We use a specially handmade solution, which is extremely powerful. It's like those light sticks you break. Two fluids come together and they emit light. Well, this is similar. We spray a solution. When it comes in contact to blood, it will lighten up. We did a test on it, but sadly, no results. It could still be there, yeah, but we are not able to find it.
With no trace of blood, the murder theory is thrown into doubt. The Amsterdam police take the decision not to investigate the incident.
So here's the million-dollar question. If there's no blood there, then what is it?
Satellite analysts start looking for other clues.
Once you see the anomaly, you look at the patterns of life around the anomaly, and that typically tells the story of what's actually occurring on the ground.
If we zoom out a little bit on the image and we rotate it around, if you're gonna get rid of a body, why would you do it on the end of a big pier like this in the middle of a big public park? Why not put it somewhere in the woods on this island or somewhere else? The stain on the dock that we think might be blood could be something else. This could be water staining the wood a darker color.
How could such an odd water trail have gotten there? One possible answer emerges when a local in the area claims the damp patches were made by their wet dog.
And we know dogs love to run in the water And if a dog could have jumped in and come right back out, dripping all the way. Maybe this is where the dog laid down.
But forensic experts are unconvinced by the soggy dog story.
Blood doesn't like to break up. It doesn't like to flow as much as water. You would see water spread more than blood.
When you look at the actual satellite image, it actually does have that appearance of blood. It doesn't look like water.
Whether or not satellites have captured a murder taking place in this image, one thing is certain. Satellites can be and are being used to detect criminal activity.
After Hurricane Katrina, there were people that had a home they claimed was destroyed by the storm. But Google Earth showed the house was standing after the storm. When insurance investigators showed up, the house was demolished. So they were caught in an insurance scam.
The number of satellites in orbit is growing, and their image capture technology is developing fast. The eyes in the sky are seeing more than ever.
With 30 centimeter resolution of imagery, we're now able to see details on the ground that you wouldn't be able to see before. Now we can not only tell the difference between, say, a sedan and maybe an SUV or a pickup truck, we can actually tell you the color of that vehicle. We can actually tell you if the passenger left their car, their door open when they exited the vehicle.
The latest satellites have taken the technology of surveillance to a whole new level. A terrifying new weapon in the hands of the state. But also, a new chapter in the fight against crime.
For the criminal mind, it's something else that they have to be aware of, because there are eyes not just watching around them, but there are eyes watching above them.